morning, I'm Katie and we're here at Dover this morning to find out what the big deal about Dover Forest is.
For us, it's like a daily task here because we feel very happy because of the environment, the nature, the air that we don't get in from our HDB flats. It's really cool. It's like being free, and then we are open. We are actually connected to the universe.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah, you see, we are here. We are the super attractor. The sun is our energy, the source for us, for all of us.
And the other is we saw a big snake here. I have a photo I can show you.
Oh wow.
Which is quite a big snake. And then
I think it was a python.
Maybe it was a python, yeah. And then we've seen, so you can see many monitor lizards out here. Yeah. If you go further down, you see otters also. So we
have fond memories with our son coming over.
Yeah.
So we bring him at least twice a week. So he loves the whole, he gets that exposure to be one with nature and experience the diversity that it brings. So I think that's something that we're quite thankful because it's not easy to have greens all around.
Yeah, we're very grateful.
We're very appreciative, yes.
My fondest memories will be whenever I walk home from the MRT, a walk through the forest, you know, always gives me this nice sense of calm, a sense of belonging, to feel peaceful. When I was a lot younger in primary school, I remember I had a very bad day in school, and I was sitting outside my, at the time I was staying in a condominium, and I remember like how there were these clouds, you know, that were in between the buildings, and I used to ask myself where these clouds come from. And then when I was much older, I realized that, you know, these clouds, you know, can form because the amount of moisture that the forest retains, and that sort of cools the atmosphere and at the same time allows the water vapor to condense, so it creates this very nice cool environment. And I think on that day itself, I felt a lot better after experiencing that moment.
Hi, my name is Han Zong. I actually spent my childhood here in one of the earliest estates called Gimo in Block 3. And whenever I had time, I would explore the Ulu Pandan canal. So this was literally my playground. And I find that in Singapore, while the landscape has changed so fast, by coming back here, it actually brings back memories. Becomes part of my rooted memories. Just within an hour coming here, I could hear quite a few different native species of forest birds, whether it's the greater racket-tailed drongo, whether it's the long-tailed parakeets, whether woodpeckers. These are the birds that will not be able to thrive in a managed park.
The people here are so determined now to exercise, you know, out of this pandemic. Ever since we have this pandemic, we see a lot of people really come to this place to exercise.
Yeah.
Even the elderly also come here. Even they,
they are harder. My mother also walk here every day.
Yeah. You know, they really take time, you know, one step at a time to really walk. But they're happy, you know, even though it's tired.
Yeah.
But I feel that this is the only thing, the joy that money can buy, and health is the top priority now.
If there's any need for development, maybe we should use more of the brownfield sites, places which are already urbanized, instead of building a place that has taken quite a few decades, yeah, and may eventually be a good place, yeah, as a nature park.
I feel so blessed to be able to see all this, and I want like future Singaporeans to also be able to appreciate the beauty in our forests.